Our first question is from Tom. And Tom says this, been listening and watching your YouTubes, ended up buying Easy Strength. My book, Easy Strength Omnibook, Easy Strength for Fat Loss, and the Armor Building Formula are all available at danjohnuniversity.com/bookstore. Buy them all. Okay. One issue I have is poor mobility in my shoulders, specifically locking them out overhead. What is the best way to improve that? Well, let's just cut right there and let's answer this question. Tom, I work with a lot of people who want to learn the Olympic lifts, and this is the classic issue, especially with the Americans I work with. First thing I always suggest, there's two things I recommend you do every day, probably every day the rest of your life. The first is to hang, just simply hang from a bar. If you don't have a bar, and I can't, it's interesting, Tom, because you can tell I've answered this question a lot. I still get pushback when I say I think you should hang from a bar for at least 30 seconds every day. Build it up to about 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, I'm not sure you get a lot of help, but you know, there's that little thing, you'll see that little contest. We have it up at Lagoon. It's an amusement park. And then over at the mall, they had it a while ago where they test to see how long you can just simply hang. Yeah, maybe it'd be fun to win that for your kids, you know, get them a little prize. But every day I hang for 30 seconds and then I sit at the bottom of the goblet squat for 30 seconds and I just sit there and I just hang there. People overcomplicate this way too much. Whenever I say hang, I'll get questions underneath, you know, what do you mean by hang? It's like, oh my gosh, hang, you know, you grab on the bar and you let your weight hang. Goblet squat, I push my knees out at the bottom because that's an area of you know, general tightness my entire life, so it helps. If you don't have a facility for hanging, there is a yoga position called the child's pose, and I do it the original strength style, or what's called pendiculation, where when I'm in there, I make small rocking, I nudge myself into a more open position. Just look up child's pose. It's a pretty famous position. Honestly, for most of the older people I work with, and Tom, I'm just guessing you're a little bit older than, you know, a young teenager, overhead squats, which is why I push them so hard. You know, I think my first published weightlifting article was on the overhead squat. And so we're looking back in time, 26, 27 years ago. I've always loved the overhead squat because I think it's a one-step assessment too. You know, when I have my athletes drop into the bottom of a overhead squat, and we just do it with a broomstick sometimes, I look at their chin, sternum, and zipper lines. I look to see if they're leaning too hard on one side or the other. I can get great feedback on their shoulder mobility, their mid-back, their lower back, their hips, their ankles, everything with one look. If you do train hard, and there's all kinds of things that'll get you sore. Personally, the squat family has always made me sore. So I will see my mobility change by the soreness of, say, high rep back squats or something like that. So first thing I'd like you to do, Tom, is I'd like you to think about nudging yourself into overhead squat, the overhead squat position. So I want you to hang for 30 seconds. I want to sit at the bottom of the goblet squat for 30 seconds. And in addition, I have a drill here on my YouTube channel where we do goblet squats into the overhead squat. It's in my perfect workout, which is just a funny name I came up with because I thought it was a good workout and, you know, I enjoy hyperbole. So that's a nice thing I'd like you to move to after that. And then from there, Tom, I think I would, if I were you, I would hang goblet squat every day, 1, 2, 3 times a week, goblet squat, overhead squat drill. Give yourself 2 weeks of that. And then just, you know, either a light bar. I have the women's bar in my gym. Obviously the empty Olympic bar, 20 kilos might be fine. Try it out there. Take your time with the overhead squat. It's not as friendly as some of the other lifts in the gym. It takes a lot of mobility, that flexibility thing. It does take some overall body strength. And there is a bit of a learning curve for your whole system. Thank you, Tom. I enjoyed that question.